Hello, friends of the robotics. Maybe you have seen one of my videos trying to open a beer bottle with a huge robot. So today I want to share with you part of my adventure realizing all this crazy stuff. Let's start with the robot itself. It's a really beautiful 1-ton piece of engineering. Being able to carry loads up to 200 kilograms and position them with a precision of 0.3 millimeters. It's more than 20 years old, and it's still amazing to see how precise and smooth it still works. As you can see, it was a pretty tight fit to get the robot into my garage, and still you can see the traces of my learning curve. In order to keep the robot mobile, a friend of mine designed for me this tube frame, serving as a support for the robot. This allows me to move the robot with a pallet jack in case I would need to. In the front of the robot, I mounted a standard pneumatic gripper that I adapted with these two brackets to my application. In top of the gripper, you can see a Raspberry Pi, which I used to host the web server for the online bar and the scripts for the object detection, allowing me to detect the position of the bottles with this webcam. A robot is nothing without its controller. Here you see the KRC1 controller that came with the robot, as well as the teach pad you need to manipulate and program the robot. The robot controller basically consists of two components: the industrial PC you see here in the front, and the power module in the back controlling the six motors. This industrial PC still runs Windows 95, but you would be astonished how fast the installation of Windows 95 is compared to modern operating systems. By default, the robot controller only has virtual inputs and outputs. But this industrial PC has this DeviceNet interface, which allows you to connect a field bus controller. Why you need this, we'll see next. On the side of the robot controller, I have mounted a board with a DeviceNet controller, which communicates over the DeviceNet interface with the robot controller. The DeviceNet controller makes available real-world inputs and outputs. We need, for example, to read the proximity switches on the gripper in order to be sure if the gripper is open or closed. Moreover, we need the outputs to activate the pneumatic valves to open and close the gripper. Below the DeviceNet controller, you see a Raspberry Zero with an RS232 shield. This Raspberry forms a gateway, allowing me to send the position of the bottles over Wi-Fi to the robot with its RS232 interface. As already said before, the gripper is pneumatic, so here you have the installation to control the gripper with a small compressor producing the compressed air, and in the back a pneumatic valve that can be electrically controlled by the robot controller. So far, you have seen most parts of the hardware required to make a robot work. At the end of this video, I would now like to show you a piece of the software I programmed in order to detect the position of the bottles. On this tablet, you can see the desktop of the Raspberry Pi connected to the webcam. On this Raspberry Pi, I am running a Python script detecting the positions of the bottles and showing the result live in a picture. In green are marked all the Corona bottles, and in pink the bottle the robot would pick up next. I am now adding another Corona bottle live into the fridge, and you should see, with a little lag, the result of the analysis, detecting another bottle and switching the next bottle to be picked up. Okay, friends, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to have more details, don't hesitate to take a look on my homepage. Most of the steps of this 2-year-long adventure are described there in detail. So have fun. Bye.